In Adobe Captivate 6, now we can convert any text into a hyperlink. And what is the advantage of hyperlinks? It can actually link to any external pages or documents, or it can even act as an interactive object. I will show you how we can use that to open an external web page or to link to a slide within the project. First, let's take a look at this slide where I'm explaining the camera basics, where I'm explaining lens, aperture, and shutter speed. While my learner is reading through the material, if I want them to click through each keywords and go to the respective slides, then I can always convert that word into a hyperlink. To do that, first double click on the text caption to get into the editing mode, and then select the word for which you need to link to another slide. And then in my properties panel, under the format accordion, we have a new icon called insert hyperlink. Click on that. Now the hyperlink not only can link to a web page or an external document, but also can do much more actions like any other interactive object. In this case, instead of opening a web page, I am selecting the slide and then select the slide where I would like to navigate to. And in this case, it is shutter speed. And then click OK. If you observe, like any other hyperlinks, which is by default in an HTML document, you get the blue color and the underline for the hyperlink depicting that this is a hyperlink. And of course, we can always customize the look of this hyperlinks. Let me just select that portion alone and then go to the character accordion and then change the color to something different. And then let's undo the underline so that whenever we see the light yellow color, we know that this is a hyperlink. Let's take a quick preview of how it would look or it would work in actual published document. I'm just previewing the five slides, and here when I click on shutter, you can observe that it is taking me to a shutter speed slide. Now I will show you another use case of how we can link this to an external web page. And not only we can do that, but also how do we place this in master slide so that all the slides which are inherited from that master slide gets the hyperlink. Isn't it cool? Because now we can not only create interactive buttons using smart shapes and place them in a master slide, but also place hyperlinks in the master slide so that you can navigate to the respective slides from film strip slides. Let me just show you how to do that. I'm going to the master slide, which is content and caption, and left, and then because I have taken all this content from an external website, I would like to put a courtesy link here. So what I'm going to do is insert a text caption, and then let's bring that text caption to the bottom, and let me select a different style for this body text. And then I would say content courtesy, and then copy the link and then put it here. So let's see how my text caption looks. This is good. Let me just make it a little more bigger so that the entire link is accommodated here. Yes, good. Now, let me select the entire link. And then go to the format accordion and then click on the insert hyperlink. And I would like to open a web page, which is again the same link, and click OK. Now, if you think the link is too big, you can always modify it. How to modify it? Just select the link part of it, and then you can say, click here. And let me put it in the same line, click here. So my link would take me to the web page mentioned in this. Good. Now, how do we format this? As I had explained earlier, let me just take a different color and undo the underline. Now, whichever slides associated with this master slide will get the link as well. If you observe, you can see the link here. Let's preview and see how it works. Click on click here and it opens up the web page. Another important information I would like to share is, earlier, prior to Adobe Captivate 6, if we had a PowerPoint file which contains an hyperlink, we had to redo the hyperlink when we import that PowerPoint slide into Captivate. But now, if you have hyperlinks in a PowerPoint slide and import that PowerPoint slide inside Captivate, all those hyperlinks are intact and works perfectly. I hope this helps. If you have any queries, get in touch with us and we'll be very happy to help you. Thank you.